Here we are back on the 2008 X5 E70. We took this one out, we clean it, we put a new fuses, and we clean the fuses. Some of them we clean it. So now I'm gonna show you how we're gonna put it back. Hold it like this. Hold like this. We're gonna hold it from here, only from here. Okay. Hold like this. We're gonna put all the boxes. So okay. See where the connection is.
Okay.
So now here. This one is going to be in this area. If it's not, we're going to look for which places. Sometime it could be here, sometime it could be not here. So it's not. Maybe here. Okay, now let me go with this one, the big one here. If it's not here, we're going to look for other place. Okay. This is one, but you see, when you take it out, it will push the fuse back out.
Okay.
Look here, look here. The camera must be here. When you put it, be sure that the fuse have to be good. Okay. Now, I'm gonna go for the next one. This one gonna be here. Okay. Yes. Gonna be like this, maybe. Yes. When you push it in. Be sure that all the fuse have to go back, so we know that two black, one is here, one is here. Now I'm gonna go to the next, the blue one. Yes, this is the blue one here. Okay, and then I'm gonna go to this one, maybe it's here. If it's not, yes. Look at the fuse jump. Be sure the fuse must not jump. Now we're gonna go here to the next level. Maybe this. It could be here. It could be this one. We are not sure, but just try it. But if you have this video, you may not make mistake. This is not. Maybe this one here, yes. I push it in. Be sure here, no fuse jump. You see this fuse jump. Because the fuse take from the circuit board and give it to the connector directly. This one here is the one that we tried to take it last time. It give us hard time, I believe this way. When you put it in, then if you want to take it out, you have to put a screw from here. And it go all the way down and it come out. Now we have one here. Let me see. Yes. Push the fuse from the back. Review your fuses. Now we have one here. The purple one. Also be sure that fuse must not jump. And the last one here. Even though we have a lot of fuses, and I believe we have one here. Okay, this one is done, and then you can go up there. This is the place where it sits. I'm gonna leave it like this because maybe we have to do a test. Okay, and here are some of the modules. We have a battery. Now we're gonna bring a battery charger. We put it on the front.
Okay.
And we're gonna see if we'll be able to get power to those fuses here. You see those fuses here? Those fuses here or those fuses here? We need to be sure that we have some power on it. Okay. So we are going to open the hood. Okay. Put this one on the floor. Have a place here. Okay, now put this one here. Okay, just move it a little back, turn it this way. Now turn the connector slowly. Yeah, just take it here. Good. That's enough. Okay, now put put negative here. Positive there.
Where?
Yeah, you see.
You see?
Mm-hmm. No. This one, yes. Got, yeah. That's it. That's enough. Now we're going to bring the cable to charge it, okay? Okay, I don't like this. Okay, this battery is kind of weak, so I'm going to support the battery with this one. So I'm going to put this negative here because the car battery may be weak a little bit. And then we're going to open the ignition and see. Okay. Let me see how many volts I have. Yeah, it's 13 volts. Good. Now we're going to see if we'll be able to communicate. Let me see what it is. No, it's good.
Oh, okay.
It's good. This is a smart charger.
Okay.
So here is good. It's smart charger. Come here, I'll show you what. Here. Here, look here. It's at 13. 13.6. Now we are going to check if we really, after we turn the ignition on, we have power there or not. If not, then we're gonna check it seriously. That fuse box was no good. Let me see now. Put the ignition on. I don't see no transmission. Here still also I have nothing. No light here coming. So we have to start. We still transmission, no power, nothing is there. So we have to get a Tesla light and see why we are not getting power there. We are going to get the computer for the BMW tools, and we're gonna start working with it correctly. Stay with us.